This year, in 2019, the first trip around the world will celebrate its 500th anniversary, the first circumnavigation. The name comes from the Latin verb circumnavigar. Circum means around and navigar, which means to sail. The year was 1519, and using the ship Victoria, Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese navigator at the service of the Spanish crown, began the first single voyage of global circumnavigation. But the main objective of the mission wasn't to be a first trip around the world. The expedition's goal, which it accomplished, was to find a western route to the Moluccas, the Spice Islands, and establish trade with Asian kingdoms through a western route, since the Portuguese controlled the eastern ones under the Treaty of Tordesillas. The fleet initially consisted of about 270 men and 5 ships, 4 carracks and 1 caravel. The trip was also known as the Magellan Elcano Expedition, and it lasted from 1519 to 1522. It was led by Magellan until 1521 and by Juan Elcano in the final year, a Spanish explorer. The voyage started in Seville, and they passed the Strait of Gibraltar, immediately turning south to cross the vast and still largely unknown Atlantic Ocean. Now, as we can imagine, a trip by sea at this time must have not been the most comfortable thing. The ships were pretty small when you think of it, and the sleeping, eating, and hygiene situations probably weren't ideal, to say the least. So, shortly after leaving Seville, they had their first stopover. They arrived on the Canary Islands on September 26th of 1519, so 6 days after beginning the voyage. This was their final stop in Europe, although the islands are off the African coast, but since they were Spanish, you know what I mean, before heading towards South America. Their trip actually wasn't that long. They arrived at the Santa Lucia Bay on the 13th of December of that same year, only just over 2 months after they set sail from the Canary Islands, and thus began their tour of the South American coast. About 1 month later, they arrived at Rio de la Plata, on the 12th of January of 1520. After several stopovers and passing by many locations on the now Argentine coast, the expedition reached the final tip of South America, crossing into the Pacific through what would then be known as the Strait of Magellan. Entering the Pacific, they discovered a number of islands on their way, including Guam, before arriving in the Philippines. Some say that the arrival in the Philippines was a pivotal point in the Spanish colonization of the archipelago, but the Philippines were a decisive stopping point for the voyage for another reason, because it was there that in April of 1521, Magellan died in battle. After this, Elcano took command of the expedition and continued the journey across the Indian Ocean. It wasn't only Magellan who was unlucky. The whole crew faced numerous hardships, including mutinies, starvation, scurvy, storms, hostile encounters with indigenous people, amongst others. Their last Indian Ocean stop was in Timor on the 25th of January of 1522. Then, according to the map I used for reference, there weren't any more stopping points in the Indian Ocean. And on the 19th of May of 1522, the expedition crossed the Cape of Good Hope in Africa, returning to the native Atlantic Ocean. There don't seem to be any stops in the African coast, but they did have one final stop before returning to Seville. And this is a fun, interesting fact. When they left Sevilla, the fleet at the command of the Portuguese Magellan stopped in the Spanish Canary Islands. And returning, the fleet now commanded by the Spanish Elcano stopped in the Portuguese islands of Cape Verde on July 9th of the same year. After that, on the 6th of September, they returned to Sevilla and completed a full trip around the world. Although it is said that only Elcano and a small group of 18 men and 2 ships actually made the full circumnavigation. They aimed to discover a profitable western trade route to the Moluccas and Asia. And while they sort of did, it was much longer and more arduous than expected, and therefore was not commercially useful. Nevertheless, the first circumnavigation has been regarded as a great achievement in sea travel and had a significant impact on the European understanding and exploring of the world. Thank you for watching this video. Remember to subscribe if you want to catch future ones. Leave a comment below with your opinions, corrections, and suggestions. Until next time.